This is a short conceptual problem that involves a gas phase reaction in a packed bed reactor. We have a simple isomerization reaction of the form A goes to B. It's conducted in this reactor. We know that there is a significant pressure drop in this reactor that is going to affect the kinetics. We're told that there is a molar flow rate of 1 butanol observed at the outlet of the reactor of 10 moles per minute under a certain mode of operation. And then what we're going to do is replace the catalyst particles used here with larger catalyst particles, so larger spheres perhaps. Right, and then we're just asking what's going to happen to that molar flow rate, if anything, assuming that as we change the size of the particles, that the rate of diffusion into those catalyst particles is still very fast, and so is not limiting the reaction. Based on the Ergen equation, or just thinking about it, as we increase the size of the catalyst spheres, so this is often described as the diameter of the particle, capital D sub P. So as that goes up, then we expect the rate of pressure drop with respect to catalyst mass to go down. All right, so that is a negative sign. That's why I'm taking the absolute value. All right, but we expect that the rate with which the pressure drops is going to go down as we have these larger spheres inside the reactor. Okay, the reason for that is these larger spheres produce less frictional losses. And so you can think about it as that it's harder to flow gas past very small particles like sand than very large particles like golf balls packed into a catalytic reactor. And so we're going to have this slower rate of pressure drop. The way the slower rate of pressure drop will affect the kinetics is that if we envision that we'll want to write a material balance for this reaction. And so we can write it on A since the problem asks about A. And so the material balance is that the change in the flow rate of molar flow rate of A with respect to catalyst mass will be equal to the reaction rate. And this will be equal to some rate constant times the concentration of our reactant to some power. For a simple isomerization reaction, it might be a first order type dependence. All right, but we'll in general expect a positive order dependence on the reactant. All right, we can further express this as a rate constant, right, times a molar flow rate of A over a volumetric flow rate. All right, and the net result of having reduced pressure drop is that we're going to have increased concentration of A throughout the reactor. All right, and where that comes from is that the volumetric flow rate, as the pressure drops to compensate for that, if we're doing this reaction isothermally, the only way that we can have the pressure drop and still obey an equation of state is to have the volumetric flow rate rise as the pressure drops. But the volumetric flow rate won't rise as much, so the volumetric flow rate will go up by less as we decrease the pressure drop by using these catalyst particles. And so since this term will overall be smaller in the reactor, all right, and that term shows up in the denominator, all right, then we're going to expect that the molar flow rate of A is going to drop more quickly. And so then FA will be less than 10 moles per minute. We'll, in other words, have larger conversion because we'll have reduced pressure drop. And that means that we won't increase the volumetric flow rate as much so that we can have a higher reaction rate in the reactor due to that higher concentration of A.